السماوات والأرض بقادر على أن يخلق مثلهم بلى وهو الخلاق العليم إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون فسبحان الذي بيده ملكوت كل شيء وإليه ترجعون.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, one of the undeniable realities regarding our existence in this world, that one day we will face death, we will die. Not only that, we will be raised up again, will be resurrected. والنصوص, the Quran and Sunnah, wealth of it regarding this. Not only that, the final courtroom you will experience will be the one right after resurrection, the ultimate. And who will preside in this courtroom? The absolute judge, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No appeals, no reconsiderations. وَاللَّهُ يَحْكُمُ لَا مُعَقِّبَ لِحُكْمِهِ وَهُوَ سَرِيعُ الْحِسَابِ. Accuracy of the reckoning, the autumn. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. Autumn, the weight of the autumn. Deeds will be weighed, placed in the scale. You will be given books. وَنُخْرِجُ لَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ كِتَابًا يَلْقَاهُ مَنْشُورًا اقْرَأْ كِتَابَكَ كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ حَسِيبًا. Read your book. Read your book. Everything is recorded. To the extent that some individuals will reject witnesses from outside themselves. Allah will seal their mouth and their body parts will speak against them. اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يعملون. All this beautiful, inspiring Quran and Sunnah falls in أصل الإيمان, the origin of your faith, that you have تصديق of that. You believe in this. You don't deny any of that. You say, هذا هو التصديق. This is the origin of faith, تصديق. But to a lot of Muslims, it's only an acknowledgement. Oh, I know that stuff. Meaning, it does not generate work. He only knows that. You know, to an extent, al-karramiyya. We have a sect in the Muslim world called al-karramiyya. أتباع محمد بن كرام. They actually defined iman to be المعرفة, اللي هو recognition, that you recognize these things. That's all. But it leads to actions, no. But أهل السنة والجماعة, that تصديق, this attestation, that's the word, that you attest to that, تشهد. It's deep rooted in your hearts. This must inside generate actions of the heart. So the heart must act. How? Fear. Imagine you're going to be standing in the land of gathering. If these texts do not make you fear, then you have not read it properly. Imagine the people who deserve security most, Allah's messengers, on this day when people approach them to intercede for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to initiate reckoning, they will say no. And they will say what? Inna Allah qad ghadiba ghadaban. If that text doesn't inspire you to fear, you know, you're going to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But again, when we say fear, the fear which doesn't send you to despair, because there is an axis of fear that is not good, that you actually despair, that you, I'm no good, you know, I don't think I'm going to make it. I'm all bad. Yeah, you know, fear like what? Like, I tell you guys, you know, there is some guy who's going to break into your house tonight. There is a guy who steals the houses. So you fear, you should fear, but that fear should do what to you? That you go to locksmith and buy some decent locks and secure your house. That is the fear, constructive fear, the fear that inspires you to work. وذلك وأما من خاف مقام ربه ونهى النفس عن الهوى. If you fear maqam, that you stand in front of Allah, you're going to stand in front of Allah. So are you concerned about this? What are you going to tell Allah? What are you going to say to Allah about what you've done with your life? So does this standing in front of Allah makes you fear? Look at this. فَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. He acted upon that fear, that he confined his nafs from luring, craving for whims and desires. That he acted upon that fear. Also, hope. Too much fear is not good. Hope that Allah will let you go, will forgive you. But again, not the type of hope that you end up with a wishful thinking mentality oh, Allah is forgiving. And that's many Muslims falling into that trap, by the way. Brother, how come you don't pray five times? Ah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. There's two, hope, but is not the right brand of hope. If you truly hope in Allah, that hope should send you to work. Again, brothers and sisters in Islam, this tasdiq must generate fear, hope, which must lead to action. Action like what? You know, when we have a meeting, you know, like I have a meeting next week on Saturday, inshallah, or on Tuesday. Very important meeting. Huh? What do you do? You prepare a PowerPoint. How I'm going to present myself and how I can convince. Feasibility study, that's what we have in this world. You know, when you want to be successful, you do a feasibility study for what you do. You know, if you want to sell something, so have you ever prepared for that meeting with Allah? What kind of deeds will it be accepted on that day? I mean, this is a serious business. This is not something that we should take light or we should belittle. It should be something that is taken seriously, brothers and sisters in Islam. Now, Quran and Sunnah expounded on this so much so that scholars identified two elements which make a good deed which Allah will accept on the Day of Judgment. They called them pillars of the act. First of them, you must do what you do sincerely for the sake of Allah. This is number one. If the act is ritualistic, in the area of rituals, salah, zakah, hajj, fasting, you must adhere to the way the Prophet ﷺ did that act. Al-ikhlas wal-mutaba'ah, those two. If you want an act that will benefit you on this day, you must make sure that those two pillars or element, or those two elements are present in the act, that you do the act for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanallah, ya ikhwa, those two pillars were mentioned in half a verse in the Quran. The last verse in Surah Al-Kahf. Look at this. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. هكذا. So if you're really caring about that لقاء, that meeting that you will have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then make sure that the deed is righteous. قال الفضيل بن عياض رحمه الله أصوبه وأخلصه. That it must be done sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also it should be done in accordance with the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, today I want to address that subject of sincerity. And ya ikhwa Allah, yani, يقول لك إيه وغير تقى يأمر الناس بالتقى. Unrighteous telling you to be righteous. يعني I'm not claiming to have that. طبيب يداوي الناس والطبيب عليل. A doctor who's trying to cure people and the doctor himself is sick. So we're all striving for sincerity. Just to, you know, to be clear here. الإخلاص. That you do something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وده يا إخوة الإخلاص هذا توفيق من الله سبحانه وتعالى. It's something that Allah instills in the hearts, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives it to you. Oh, the danger of ikhlas lacking it is you end up with the opposite, which is shirk. Now some of you may say, how can ikhlas, lack of ikhlas, lack of sincerity, amounts to shirk, to polytheism? Yeah, actually major shirk too, major polytheism that can take you out of the fold of Islam. When the scholars categorized major shirk, and when I say major shirk, that you're no longer a Muslim, the person no longer a Muslim, they said there are four areas. Number one, shirk al-du'a, the supplication, that you supplicate to someone beside Allah, major shirk. Or you supplicate to someone in association with Allah. Ya Tijani, Ya Rifa'i, Ya Hussein, hakada. Or in the name of Jesus, like Christians do, the Son, the Holy Ghost, hada huwa. That's shirk al-du'a. The second type, shirk al-mahabba, polytheism in the area of love, that you love someone so much so that you place him ahead of Allah and His Messenger. Like Sheikh Dagh, the Sufi spiritual path, they call them path with a P, Shuyukh al-Tariqah. That when you follow a sheikh and you give that sheikh a pledge, khalas, whatever that sheikh tells you, you're done. Sufi trending. Or the Christians loving Jesus so much so that they placed him ahead of Allah. Allah is no longer existing and Jesus is the main character now. Shirk al-mahabba. And by the way, this is the first type of shirk that emerged in the face of this earth and emerged in Qawm Nuh and the people of Nuh. وَقَالُوا لَا تَذَرُنَّ آلِهَتَكُمْ وَلَا تَذَرُنَّ وَدًّا وَلَا سُوَاعًا وَلَا يَغُوثَ وَيَعُوقَ وَنَسْرًا. Those are five righteous people. They loved them dearly, that they ended up worshipping them. Imagine this. Nuh spent 950 years to take them out of that domain. Come to Allah. La waddan suwa'an. No, we love them. So this is number two. The third, shirk al-ta'a. Shirk in the area of obedience. That you obey someone at the expense of Allah. Adi ibn Hatim was a Christian. When he came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was wearing that huge cross, Hadith al-Bukhari. Someone happened to recite that verse in front of him in Surah At-Tawbah. Ittakhadhu ahbarahum wa ruhbanahum arbaban min dunillahi wal masih ibn Maryam. They have taken their priests, in reference to the people of the book, the Christian and the Jews, and their rabbis as two gods beside Allah. Two gods beside Allah. And Jesus. Adi right away, he said, Ya Rasulallah, Wallahi ma abadnahum. We never worship them. That is not true. We don't worship them. The Prophet said to him, أَلَا يَحِلُّونَ لَكُمُ الْحَرَامِ وَيُحَرِّمُونَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْحَلَالِ فَتِلْكَ عِبَادَتُهُمْ. Don't they legalize, halalize what is haram? And don't they make unlawful what is halal? تِلْكَ عِبَادَتُهُمْ. That's how you worship them. أَمْ لَهُمْ شُرَكَاءُ شَرَعُوا لَهُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا لَمْ يَأْذَنْ بِهِ اللَّهِ تِلْكَ عِبَادَتُهُمْ. Like the Pope, the Catholic Pope, like I think a year ago, For years, the LGBTQXYZ is no. He came and he said, okay, we'll change that part of the family. طيب, who giving you that authority? هذا هو. The fourth type, which is relevant to my subject, شرك النوايا, شرك in the area of intention. That when you do something, you're not doing it for Allah. You're doing it for some other motive. It can be the dunya, it can be position. شرك النوايا, the shirk in the area of intention. And this is, by the way, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned against it. That it can actually amount to the major shirk which takes a Muslim out of the fold of Islam. In general, brothers and sisters in Islam, shirk is a very dangerous thing. Yani, just one reality about shirk. العلماء يقولون, the scholars, they say, the nature of good deeds, the nature of good deeds, they erase bad deeds. You know, when you do something wrong, ideally, you should follow that with something good. اتبع, the Prophet said that to Mu'adh or Abi Dharr, two words. اتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحوها. Follow a bad deed with a good deed, it will erase it. قال تعالى إن الحسنات يذهبن السيئات. Good deeds erase bad deeds. طيب, do bad deeds erase good deeds? I'm asking you, do bad deeds erase good deeds? The answer is no. But there is one bad deed, if you do, it will erase everything that you've done. وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ. It was revealed to you, O Muhammad, and to the prophets and messengers who came before you. If you commit shirk, all your good deeds are gone. All of it are gone. ذكر الله تعالى, الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned 18 prophets and messengers in Surah Al-An'am, chapter Al-An'am, which talks about Tawheed and Shirk, this particular chapter. وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ كُلًّا هَدَيْنَا وَنُوحًا هَدَيْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِهِ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِهِ دَاوُودَ وَسُلَيْمَانَ وَأَيُّوبَ وَيُوسُفَ وَمُوسَى وَهَارُونَ وكذلك نزل المحسنين وزكريا ويحيى وعيسى وإلياس كل من الصالحين وإسماعيل واليسع ويونس ولوطا وكلا فضلنا على العالمين. Look at this. لو أشركوا لحبط عنهم ما كانوا يعملون. If they commit shirk, no good. Shirk is an awful sin that you want to free yourself from it. Which is, you set a partner with Allah. Even, ya ikhwa, subhanallah, in our human realm or domain, in our human interaction, we don't like shirk. We don't like partners. You don't like partners, do you? If you have a business, you want to be the sole owner. You want to be the decision making. You don't want someone to come and question you. You don't like that. Why do you associate this to Allah? Why do you say Allah has a partner? The question here, when do we need partners as human? Just let's take this slow here. When do we need partners? When you lack financial resources, no money. When you lack knowledge, experience. You know, some people, they go into partnership because, listen, I'm a guru in that field, IT, but I don't have the money. Can you put the money and I will invest for you? So, when you lack experience, in some partnerships, you have what is called, or what is known by, silent partner. A partner who put the money and he doesn't want. Or when you lack power, you know, in some corrupt societies, you need people who know what, how to work, how to get a contract from the military, how, you know, the inner circle in some countries like that, you know, how to pay the you know, the bribery, and you know this guy, and you call this guy. Question you, does Allah lack any of these? Huh? Money? هو الغني الحميد. He's the all rich. He's all rich. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, يد الله ملأ, the hands of Allah are full. سحاء. You know what سحاء means? Like that sail that we had, that drain that we had here. Always rains. لا يغيضها كم أنفق. It doesn't decrease anything from what he spends. انظر إليه كم أنفق منذ خلق السماوات والأرض. Just look how much did he spend since he created the heavens and the earth. غني حميد. He doesn't need partner. Why do you give him a partner then? Does Allah need financial resources to help you? To help his creation? Why? Why do you do that? Knowledge. عليم الخبير. All knowing. يسمع دبيب النملة السوداء على الصخرة الصماء في الليلة الظلماء. He hears the drumming of the feet of the black ant walking on a rock at a dark night. Why do you give him a partner then? Because he lacks knowledge? وعنده مفاتيح الغيب لا يعلمها إلا هو ويعلم ما في البر والبحر وما تسقط من ورقة إلا يعلمها. A leaf falls, he knows it. So why do you give him a partner? Why do you give him a helper? Why do you give him associates? Why? Huh? What else? Power? Allah cannot protect his creation. وهو يجير ولا يجار عليه. Look at this. هو يجير ولا يجار عليه. سبحان الله. When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would make this dua before he goes to sleep, لا منجا ولا ملجأ منك إلا إليك. The only one you can say, I run away from you to you. The only one. The only one you can say that. Normally when you say I'm running away from you, huh, you go somewhere else. No, to you. لا ملجأ. No shelter. No safe haven. From you, except with you. ولذلك يا إخوة المشرك هذا, المشرك, the one who commits polytheism, who associates someone in worship with Allah سبحانه وتعالى, has lost his senses. That he goes and he identifies someone to be an associate with Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وشوف يوم القيامة حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه. Look at this. Allah says what? أنا أغنى الشركاء عن الشرك. I'm the most sufficient. I do not need any partners. I do not need partners. فمن عمل عملا أشرك فيه معي غيري تركته وشريك. If you did something and you associated someone in worship with me, you go and your partner. And by the way, some of these partners will denounce. إذ تبرأ الذين اتبعوا من الذين اتبعوا ومن أضل ممن يدعو من دون الله من لا يستجيب لهم إلى يوم القيامة وهم عن دعائهم غافلون. Jesus will say to the Christians of today, I never told you to do that. What is this? أنت قلت للناس اتخذوني وسبحانك ما يكون لي. Never did. They made this stuff up. ولذلك يا إخوة سبحان الله, look at the mushrik, the one who associates someone in worship with Allah. يؤتى بالرجل, a man will be brought in the day of judgment, and Allah will say to him, ألا إن كان لك ملء الأرض ذهبا Someone who committed shirk, he's to be thrown into hell. So Allah will ask him, if you would have had earth filled with gold, wouldn't you use that gold to ransom you from hell today? He says, yes, Ya Rab, I will. I would use all this gold to ransom to be safe. Allah will say to him, I ask you to do something in the dunya less than that. I ask you not to associate someone in worship with me. وَأَخَذْتُ عَلَيْكَ الْمِيثَاقَ وَأَنْتَ فِي ظَهْرِ أَبِيكَ آدَمَ. And I establish a covenant with you when you are in the back of Adam. وَإِذْ أَخَذَ رَبُّكَ مِنْ بَنِي آدَمَ مِنْ ظُهُورِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ وَأَشْهَدَهُمْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَىٰ شَهِدْنَا. ميثاق الفطرة, فطرة, فطرة. You look up there when you're in trouble. Look up. Fitra. Subhanallah, and Allah doesn't hold us accountable based on that fitra. Because Allah knows that some parents neglect the fitra. They thrown their children into the waves of shirk. Swim, my child, in the public school. Swim. They teach you for 12 years, no God. You can be happy without God. You can be successful without God. Swim, my son, swim. And I want you to come out a Muslim, practicing Muslim, my son. Ya Salah. Wallah. Wallah, you're dreaming. Wallah, you're dreaming. Now add to it morality now. The list is morality. Huh. Are you sure you're a man or you're a boy? Huh? That's what's going on now. Shahid is, I have taken it. Allah doesn't hold us accountable based on that fitrah, that covenant. Huh? No, he sends messengers. Actually, the accountability will be contingent upon receiving a messenger. Huh? Because Allah knows that some parents will neglect the fitrah of their children. وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولَهُ. We are not going to send to punish someone unless we send a messenger. فهذا هو يا إخوة الشرك. Sincerity is out there, that you do something and you associate someone with Allah. You're not doing it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm talking, be careful here, I'm talking about أصل العمل. Ibn Rajab has a beautiful writing regarding this, Al-Hanbali. I'm talking about the origin of the act. Because sometimes you would be praying. Yes, you had a sincere intention that this salah is for Allah. But then while you're praying, you know, somebody walks in that you're familiar with. Oh, Ishaq sees me praying now. Okay, let me beautify the salah now. So this occurred when? After what? After the initial. We're talking about aslul amal, the origin of the act. The origin. Okay, I'm going to do this salah so the brother can see me. He thinks that I'm righteous and pious, so he can give me $1,000. That aslu al-amala, the origin. But if somehow, you know, showing off happens after, don't entertain the thought. That's solution. Or you will get the reward of the act based on how much you entertain that thought. فَدَهَكَذَا. Ibn Rajab detailed this beautifully. I wish I have time. But there is no time for that. فالإخلاص يا إخوة. Sincerity. And subhanAllah, and that is why always when you read the Quran and Sunnah, you will find out that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants one act from you, which you done sincerely. Look at this. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ. What? That's a singular. Not a plural. Not أَعْمَالًا. لا. عَمَلًا. One act. One act. Sincerely. Well, our righteous predecessors, they would say, well, if I would know that I have done something sincerely, Allah accepted it, I would say, I'm ready to go. Ready to go. And by the way, the fact that you're still alive, I'm still alive, that means that act is not there yet. Yani, some scholars said that. So keep working. Keep working. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين، وعلى من اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. On the day of judgment, brothers and sisters in Islam, some people will come with humongous deeds, huge, but no benefit. They are Muslims, no benefit, because they lack that pillar. الإمام الترمذي والنسائي وصححه ابن خزيمة وابن حبان. They compiled this beautiful narration. A predecessor, his name is Shafi or Shufi, one of the two. Or some people said Shufa or Shifa. Shufi ibn Mati' al-Himyari. A predecessor, the second best generation of Muslims. Someone who came from Himyar, a tribe in the Arabia. He came to Medina. قال دخلت المدينة. I entered Medina. فإذا شيخ كبير حوله الناس. And I saw an old man and people are surrounding them, surrounding him. After he finished, the people left. فإذا هو أبو هريرة. It was أبو هريرة. صاحب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. فهي approached him and said, listen, I came all the way from Himyar, long way traveling. Now do me a favor. حدثني حديثا. Cite to me, narrate to me a narration. سمعته من رسول الله. You heard it from the Messenger of Allah, not from anyone else. From the Messenger of Allah. وعقلته. And you comprehended it. You understood. وعملت به. And you acted upon it. Abu Huraira looked at him and he said, لأحدثنك حديثا. I shall narrate you a hadith. سمعته من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I heard it from the Messenger of Allah in this house, in my house. ليس معي أحد غيره. Only two of us were here. عقلته. And I understood. But he did not say, and I acted upon it. He didn't say that. فنشغ نشغ. Then he fainted like that. فانتظرت طويلا حتى أفاق. I waited a while until he regained his consciousness again. And he looked at him and he said, لأحدثنك حديثا. I shall narrate to you a hadith, a narration. سمعته من رسول الله. I heard it from the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. In this place, he repeated the same exact thing that he did. نشغ. Then he fainted again. Three times. Finally, he started narrating the hadith. And he said, إذا كان يوم القيامة. The Prophet said to me, when the day of judgment is here, نزل الله ليحكم بين الخلائق. Allah will come, will descend in a way that suits His Majesty. نثبت الصفة. لا نشبهها، لا نكيفها. مررها. We affirm the attribute. We don't resemble His descending in a human way. We don't give Allah a human context. His attributes, that's why we say that in a way that suits His majestic greatness, in a way that suits His power. ليس كمثله شيء. No one is like Allah. That's easy, easy manhaj, easy going. Don't complicate things. And don't play with your intellect. If Shaitan comes, plays with the intellect that you, he gets you to visualize Allah descending in a certain way, say, Subhanallah, Allah is above that. كُلُّ مَا دَارَ بِبَالِكَ فَاللَّهُ بِخِلَافِ ذَلِكَ. Whatever your human intellect produces about Allah, the modality, the reality, the nature of the attribute or the actions, say Subhanallah, because he's above that. That's why we say Subhanallah. هكذا. وَتَرَى كُلَّ أُمَّةٍ جَاثِيَةٍ. And every nation will be kneeling, people will be kneeling in the land of gathering. فَيُؤْتَى بِثَلَاثٍ. Three individuals will be brought in front of Allah. رَجُلٌ قَرَأَ الْقُرْآنِ. And you understand why Abu Huraira fainted. Someone who knew the Quran. ورجل جواد, and a generous man, giving. ورجل قاتل فقتل, and a man who fought and he was killed in the battlefield. فيقال لقارئ القرآن, it will be said to the one who was very eloquent with the Quran, very good with the Quran. علمتك ما أنزلت على رسولي. ما فعلت به. I taught you what I have revealed to the prophets and messengers. What did you do with it? What did you do? Allah is asking him. يا رب, O Allah, قرأته آناء الليل وآناء النهار. I recited the Quran day in and day out. I taught it. I gave khutbas about it. Allah will say to him, كذبت. You're lying. في حديث سليمان بن يسار and Muslim, the wording of Muslim, عملت ليقال وقد قيل. You did this so the people can say that, oh, this guy is a good khatib, this guy is a good scholar, this guy is, and people said it. I didn't take this away from you. I give it to you. Look, he will be dragged on his face, to the hellfire. On his face. فَيُسْحَبُ عَلَى وَجْهِهِ إِلَى النَّارِ. This is the first Muslim, not a thief, not a, I'm not saying that you go and steal, I'm not saying that, but I'm just going to tell you the essence and the significance of sincerity in what we do. Subhanallah, imagine this. من قرأ حرفا من كتاب الله. Every letter that you read from the Quran, you get 10 حسنات. 10 حسنات. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, 109 حسنة. The Prophet says, الماهر بالقرآن. The one who is eloquent with the Quran. I'm sorry. مع السفرة الكرام البررة. He will be in the company of the noble of the angels. The one who is good with the Quran. So what is the difference between this one and this one? Sincerity. This one was sincere, this one was not sincere. Likewise, Al-Jawad, the generous man. I given you money, what did you do with it? Oh, I uphold my kinch, I give it, shared it with my family. I did not leave. كذبت, you're lying. عملت ليقال وقد قيل. You said that so that people can say that you're a generous man, and you got it. You're a generous man. الشهيد likewise. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to instill in our hearts sincerity, ya Rabbil Alameen. اللهم ارزقنا إخلاصا في قول وعمل يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل يا رب العالمين. اللهم نجنا من الرياء الشرك يا رب العالمين. اللهم وفقنا إلى ما تحب وترضى, خذ بنواصينا إلى البر والتقوى. اللهم اجعلنا هداة مهديين. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى يا رب العالمين. I just want to share the good news with you that Salahuddin Future Academy has received a full Cambridge accreditation. Cambridge is an international body. If you can go to any university worldwide, Cambridge accreditation, full K-12, online, virtual, and on-site. We just received this last week by the grace of Allah, by the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like we said, we have four branches already, two in New Jersey and Philly, and one in Chicago, and we have the one here. Next year, maybe we're gonna double that, inshallah. And this is the headquarters, by the way. This is the mother place for this organization. May Allah reward you for your support. May Allah reward the parents who, you know, sacrifice. Although there was some defamation going around the community. Oh, they are not credited and all that stuff. But the parents believed in what we're doing. And alhamdulillah, we delivered by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are a candidate for CADNIA, candidacy status. And we have to go through some, you know, more procedures in order to get the final accreditation, inshallah. That's a local national organization. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us sincerity. Maybe Salahuddin will come out of that organization, inshallah.